linear programming problems are problems where you are trying to optimize something. You might want to maximize your profit. You might want to minimize cost. You might want to minimize pollution. There's some quantity that you're trying to maximize or minimize. Here's a typical example of a linear programming problem. In this instance, we have a farmer who's growing two crops, corn and soybeans, on a 320-acre farm. We have some data about the expenses of planting corn and the expenses for planting soybeans. We have storage space costs for each of the two crops. We have information on the amount of storage available and the amount of capital available. But the bottom line is, how many acres should be planted in each crop in order to maximize the profit? So you're trying to come up with a strategy which will maximize or minimize something. That's the general scenario for a linear programming problem. In order to see how we're going to approach these problems, we need to first remember a bit about graphing in an XY plane. Each point in the plane, remember, is represented by two coordinates that describes how far you are from each axis. This is the point with coordinates x equals 4, y equals 2, because we are 4 units distance to the right of the y-axis and 2 units above the x-axis. 6 minus 3, 6 to the right, and 3 down. Minus 3 minus 2.5, 3 units to the left and 2.5 units down. And here we are 2.5 units to the left of the origin and up 3.5 units. You've certainly done a lot of this in your school days. When we're graphing equations, we start out by plotting points, and typically we plot the points at which the if we're graphing a straight line, we typically graph the points. We typically start by finding the points where it crosses the x and y axis. If the line is 2x plus 5y is minus 8, we substitute in x equals 0, find that 5y is minus 8, which tells us y is minus 8/5. Substitute y equals 0 in the equation, solve for the corresponding x value, and you plot those two points. If x is 0, y is minus 8/5, this is the point plotted down here. If y is 0, x is minus 4, here's the point x equals minus 4, y equals 0. And then to graph the line, you just draw the line through those two points. So what we're indicating when we graph that line is that any point that lies on this line will have coordinates which satisfy that equation. This equation is known as a linear equation because its graph is a straight line. Here's a line 3x minus 5y whose graph passes through the origin. So you can't graph this line by plotting the place where it crosses the two axes, because the two axes, it crosses both axes at the origin. So you need some point which is not that point in order to graph the line. And you can graph this line by simply taking any x or y value which is not 0. The point that's shown here is the value x equals 5. If you take x to be 5 and substitute into this equation, you have 3 times 5 is 15 minus 5y is 0. So 5y is 15, y has to be 3. So you just grab one point that's not the origin, plot it, and then your line goes through the origin and through that point. Now, when we solve linear programming problems graphically, we're going to have to find all the points in the plane that satisfy a certain linear inequality. Here's an example of a linear inequality. What points in the plane satisfy the condition 2x minus 3y is less than or equal to 6? We want to draw a picture of that set of points. The first thing we do is graph the corresponding straight line. So if we're looking at this inequality, 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6, the first thing we do is graph the equation 2x minus 3y equals 6. And when you graph that equation, you get the straight line that's shown in purple right here. Where do the points lie that satisfy the inequality? Let's take the inequality and transfer the 2x term over to the right side. So the inequality reads minus 3y less than or equal to 6 minus 2x. And now let's divide by minus 3 to make the inequality look like this. Remember that if you have an inequality and you multiply or divide by a negative number, as we're doing in this case, it changes the direction of the inequality. So the set of points we're looking for that satisfy this original inequality is the set of points y greater than or equal to minus 2 plus 2/3 x. Remembering that the equation that corresponds to this inequality has this line as its graph, we know that the points for which y is equal to minus 2 plus 2/3 x would be the points on this line. So the points for which the y-coordinate is greater than or equal to that would be on or above the line. So the solution region is all the points in the plane that lie on or above this purple straight line. The solution region is everything in the plane above, on or above that line. Now, suppose you've graphed the straight line and you know that the solution region is going to be the points on one side or the other. What's the easiest way to tell which side of the line the inequality solution region will be on? You can just use the origin as a test point. If we know that the solution region is the points on one side of the line or the other, substitute in x equals 0 and y equals 0 as a test point to find out. If we substitute in x equals 0 and y equals 0, what does this inequality say? Substituting those values, the inequality would read 0 less than or equal to 6. That's a true statement, isn't it? So we see that the point x equals 0, y equals 0 does satisfy the inequality, since that's a true statement. So this point is in the solution region. And that's evidence that the solution region consists of the points on this side of the line rather than the points on the other side of the line. If you took a point on the other side of the line, like for example, well, what about this point right here? Suppose we took this point where x is 6 and y is 0. Substitute those coordinates. 2 times 6 is 12 minus 0 less than or equal to 6. 12 less than or equal to 6 is a false statement. This point does not satisfy the original inequality. So the solution region is the points on this side of the line rather than the points on this side of the line, and we determine that by using the origin as a test point. Let's get a bit more complicated and look for the points that satisfy two inequalities. Find the region for the system of inequalities 2x minus 3y less than or equal to 6, and 2x plus y greater than minus 2. In the previous example, we graphed the straight line 2x minus y equals 6 and found it was the purple line showing right here. In this example, we'll need that line, and we'll also need the straight line corresponding to the equation 2x plus y equals minus 2, the equation that corresponds to this inequality. If you graph the equation 2x plus y equals minus 2, you get the green line shown right here. We need to figure out which side of the green line, whether it's the points to the right side, upper right side of it, or to the lower left side, which satisfy this inequality. And we can use 0, 0 again as our test point. If we substitute in 0, 0, 2 times 0 plus 0, 0 greater than minus 2 is true. And that tells us that the points that satisfy this inequality are the points to this side of the green line and not the points to the lower left side of the green line. So I'm going to put in a blue arrow pointing in this direction to indicate as the points to the right of the green line, which are the ones that satisfy this inequality. And from the last example, we already knew that the points to this side of the purple line satisfy the first inequality. So if we're looking at the points that satisfy both inequalities, where do we have to be? We have to be to the upper right side of the green line and to the upper left side of the purple line. And what that leaves us with is this region right in here between the two lines. The points in here are the points that are on the proper side of both lines and satisfy both of the conditions. If you want to be technical about it, the solution region includes everything in here. It includes the points on this part of the purple line because we have a less than or equal inequality right here. Strictly speaking, it does not include the points on this part of the green line because this does not say greater than or equal. Being equal would put you on the green line. It says strictly greater than. So it would be the points that are not on the green line but to the right of it. Here's an example with five conditions. We want to look for the points that satisfy 5x plus 2y greater than or equal to 25, 4x minus 3y greater than or equal to minus 3, x less than or equal to 2, x greater than or equal to 0, and y greater than or equal to 0. So we have a lot of conditions to be met in this example. The first thing we would do would be to graph one of the equations. In this picture, we have the graph of 5x plus 2y equals 25. Let's check that real quickly. If x is 0, 2y equals 25 would give us y as 12.5, which is this point right here. Or in the equation 5x plus 2y equals 25, if y was 0, 5x would be 25, so x would be 5. So we graph the equation corresponding to 5x plus 2y equals 25. We get the green line. We use 0, 0 as a test point. Plug in x equals 0, y equals 0. This inequality reads 0 greater than or equal to 25, which is false. So that tells us the solution for this inequality is not the points that include the origin, but the points on the other side of the green line, the side over here. So that's why I've drawn the blue arrow, to indicate that the first inequality, the solution region, is the points on the green line or to the right of it. Move on to the second inequality. We need to draw the straight line corresponding to the corresponding equation. So we graph the line 4x minus 3y equals minus 3, get the second green line. Let's use the origin again as the test point to test which side gives us the solution region for this inequality. Testing with x and y equals 0, we get 0 greater than or equal to minus 3, which is true, which tells us it's the side that includes the origin, which would be, for this line, it would be the side over here. So I've drawn the second blue arrow to indicate that our solution region for the second inequality is the points on or to this side of the second line. Now let's drop down and look at the bottom two constraints here. X greater than or equal to 0, that simply puts us on or to the right of the y-axis. And y greater than or equal to 0 puts us on or above the x-axis. So if you forget about this inequality for a minute, the first two, which we already analyzed, plus the bottom two, which serve to simply put us in the first quadrant, means that if we did not have this inequality in the picture, we would be to this side of the first line, this side of the second line, and in the first quadrant as indicated by the other two arrows corresponding to these two conditions. The net effect of this constraint x less than or equal to 2, here's the line x equals 2, all the points where the x-coordinate is 2. So being less than or equal to that would mean we have to be to the left side of that line. And there aren't any points that satisfy all those conditions. Let's back up. It would be this region right in here if we did not have this condition. But when you throw in that condition, it means you have to be on or to the left of this line, and there simply aren't any points in the plane that are both in this region and also to the left of that line. So the bottom line here is we have no solution. So this example simply reminds us that it's possible to write down a set of conditions, a set of linear constraints, that no point in the plane can satisfy.